Why would you want a website? Because it's fun. You can use it as a link page, like a card or a link tree, but that you own completely. You could talk about your own interests on it. You could make a blog, or an elaborate ARG, or a joke, or anything else you want. But how? Step 1. Choose a host, a service that'll put your content on the internet. There are a lot of choices for this, but I'd reckon the easiest and the most popular ones are NeoCities or NecoWeb. There are a lot of other services like GitHub Pages or Cloudflare or Vercel, but those are oriented towards a more technical workflow, so know what you're getting into with that. Either way, pick a host, sign up, and then step 2, make your page. You'll need to learn how to write some basic HTML and CSS for this. It's not complicated, don't worry. NeoCities has a good tutorial covering the basics and also some links to other helpful guides. But in short, this is a tag. These are tag attributes. Tags can hold other tags. This is the body tag. Your site content goes within the body tag. Text should be wrapped in P tags. P stands for paragraph. You can link to other pages with A tags using the href attribute. Use strong tags for bold text, EM tags for italicized text, OL or UL for ordered and unordered lists, with LI tags for each list item, and if you ever need to make a table, have fun. Step 3. Style your page. CSS is written in style tags. This is a selector, which finds everything on the page that it matches, and you add rules in the braces after selectors. You can style color, fonts, backgrounds, widths and heights, padding, margins, and lots more. Use classes for more granularity, add a class attribute to a tag, and target the class in the CSS, and it'll only style tags with that class. Save your work, and congrats, you have a website. Share it with your friends, encourage them to make their own websites, and then link to each other's sites. Now you've successfully used a markup language to create hypertext, the links between content. That's the internet. This was only a brief look into HTML and CSS, but there's lots more that it can do, especially if you get JavaScript involved, but good luck with that. Oh, and one more thing. Always be considerate of others when you're designing your site. Don't host content you don't own without permission. Don't use your site for nefarious purposes like spreading hate. And make sure everyone can use your site, including people using screen readers or reader mode. The more accessible we make the internet, the better it'll be for all of us. Now go and make a website.